This video follows a previous problem about a farmer and an injured cow, but you don't have to have seen that to appreciate this one.
All right, so this time the river is going to have width that matters. And we have a village on one side of the river and another village on the other side of the river. And I'm not going to even give you any numbers. In calculus, you'll have to set it up with some numbers and variables. In geometry, I don't know whether you need, but what the two villages want is to build a bridge across the river somewhere so that when the market happens every week in village two, the villagers from village one will walk the shortest possible path. So what do I mean by this? First, they have to get to the bridge with all of their goods, walk over, and it's going to be a long bridge. This is a wide river.
And the bridge has to be perpendicular.
Exactly. Well, yeah. Otherwise, you can just connect the two villages, but the bridge is very expensive material. So you want to minimize the length of the bridge, and then you walk to village two. So where should they build this bridge? We assume that it's the same expense anywhere down the river, as long as it's perpendicular. The river has the same width. So you want to see the cool solution?
Yeah, I feel like the width of the river is very important to this problem.
Absolutely important this time. Yeah. You cannot ignore it. And flipping over villagers is not going to work because of that width of the river. And in this scenario, we are on opposite side of the river, but that's not very helpful. Okay, so what do we do?
I don't know, but I've got a feeling you're going to flip and put the villages on the same side.
No.
No, all right.
We're not going to do that.
All right.
We are going to switch the order of things. So you have in your mind already stuck that villagers, one, are going to first walk to the bridge, then walk across the bridge, and then walk to village two. There is one part of this trip that is always fixed. This is the walking across the bridge. Why should we do it second? Why don't we just make it first? And you're like, bridge, but I don't have a bridge on the land. Again, this is us. We can do whatever we like. So I'm going to create a phantom bridge of exactly the same width going in the north direction as the intended bridge. And first I'm going to make the villagers from village one walk along that bridge of length D to the north. Then I'm going to say we still need to walk to the river has already changed, and then to the village. So from this point, what is the shortest path to the village? I'm already done with the river. Ignore the river. So I'm going to go straight to village two. There you go. And then wherever I hit the river a second time, I'm going to stop.
The second bank.
Uh-huh. I will return back. That's where my bridge will be. So this is bridge. And come back to V1. So the path that the villagers will walk is really this one to point A, across the bridge to point B, and then to V2. And I claim that that's the shortest path. So that construction of the phantom bridge along land was a very cool idea. And the flavor of this problem is, even though it is geometric, it has the flavor of vectors, using vectors. A vector is a segment of a certain length in a certain direction, and that's our bridge. The bridge is being used here as a vector. What geometric figures do you see here that helped us?
Is that a parallelogram?
It is, because when we said that I'm going to reverse the bridge back, this segment, the actual bridge, was parallel and equal to the segment V1x, and that makes this figure a parallelogram. Mm-hmm. Which means that whatever the villagers are going to first walk, that path is the same as this one, right? And so they, in real life, are going to walk like this, But the length of that path is equal to this one. And I will let to the reader reconstruct somehow the idea of the farmer, the cow here, to show that this will be indeed the shortest path. There will be another parallelogram, and there will be another triangle inequality. In fact, that's the triangle, and that's the other parallelogram, and you cannot understand anything from this picture, and that's done on purpose. So you guys need to figure it out. Good luck. So we're going to have yet another problem for homework.
You can't help yourself, can you? You can't resist giving us more homework.
Yeah, it's just so much fun. So, okay, so what do we have? We have a very weird play yard. The play yard is inside between those two fences or fence pieces that make an acute angle. And you will have to explain why I'm actually using an acute angle, why not obtuse or right here. At any rate, inside the play yard, there is one tree here and another tree somewhere, I don't know, maybe here. And so the kids cannot get out of the play yard, which is good because there's lots of cars around. And the game that they are playing is the following. You start from one tree, run to the fence, to one of the fence pieces, run to the other tree, again run to a fence piece and return. So wins the kid who can do it as fast as possible before the other kids. So you need to help the kid, your favorite kid, to win the game. So where should they run to those two fences in order to make their trip as short as possible? Because you can't help them with the speed, but you can at least help them with the length of the path. So think about the farmer cow problem, and that should be helpful.
And you haven't even told us exactly where the trees are or what the angle is.
No, and just like in the farmer cow problem, in some sense, the numbers 2, 4, and 6 didn't matter. What mattered was the actual geometric construction. The numbers were kind of an afterthought, right? So that we can pinpoint the location here. I don't even need to know the exact numbers. I just want you to show me geometrically how you construct it. Now, if you haven't seen the cow farmer problem and you try this with calculus, oh, that's going to be a horrendous problem. But the geometry one would be great. Think about when you're solving this problem, think about sunlight. And you have several mirrors. So what is the sunlight going to do? It will keep reflecting from whatever mirror it reaches, and that might be helpful.
Okay.
That's it.
Leave a comment.
But you may not see that direct way. And that's why I'm going to demonstrate for you something called strong induction. Okay, let's not get ahead of the game. Let's see what happens.